All right, good morning everyone. Day 86, which is Monday, June 27th at 6:38 in the morning. Just getting out of Shadow Cliff here. I wound up yesterday before that slack pack. I went down to the bagel shop and got bagel and lox and miraculously had the foresight to buy a second one that I could keep in the fridge and eat for breakfast this morning. So that was the breakfast plan, as well as coffee from Shadow Cliff here, which tasted for all the world like it was definitely brewed like yesterday morning, but can't beat the price anyways. Yeah, Shadow Cliff was great, man. Great, great, great spot. Definitely two thumbs up, recommend. And I would come back here. It's probably one of the first places on this trail, maybe Pagosa. But specific businesses that I would come back to, that I would consider coming back to with my wife Daphne. Because, I mean, the price is right. I think it's like a bunk room for $34 or something for a bunk, which I don't think I'd have a prayer trying to get Daph into a bunk. But you get a private room for like $90 or something, which had a queen bed in those two bunks. Yeah, I left Cricket back in the room sleeping. Speaking of those two bunks. But yeah, Shadow Cliff was great. Shadow Cliff was a really, really good time. And honestly, this whole town's pretty cute. Oh, I wound up not going to a sports bar last night to watch game six, but I definitely was following the score. And congratulations to any Avs fans watching. Colorado Avalanche, 2021-2022 Stanley Cup champions. So that's pretty cool. Bunked up at 10 o'clock last night. Got up at, 5:30 or 5 or something this morning. And now I am going to get down to Highway 34 and try and hitch the 6 or 7 miles or something back up to the Green Mountain Trailhead, which is just inside of Rocky Mountain National Park, and where I started my southbound slack yesterday. So if I can get a hitch out there, I can keep hiking north. Should be hopefully 3 days from Steamboat, and for whatever crazy reason, I guess because I resupplied before I knew I was going to slack pack, I'm carrying like 4.5 days of food in my pack, which is not great, but is what it is. It'll save me buying a little more food in Steamboat. I did text Martin as well to let him know. I guess I haven't let you guys know, but my wife has a former coworker friend named Lauren, who is currently out in Bend, Oregon, and has in the past lived in Montana. Lauren has a friend in Boulder, Colorado, named Kurt. Kurt owns a condo in Steamboat. So Daph put me in touch with Lauren. Lauren put me in touch with Kurt. I've been in touch with Kurt, and it sounds for all the world like Kurt is gonna be generous enough to donate the use of his condo for my purposes once I get to Steamboat in another few days. Also said that I could bring one more hiker if that's something that would be helpful. So I texted Martin just this morning. Of course, I haven't heard back yet, to let him know that I'll be in Steamboat hopefully on the 29th. And that I have a place for both of us for free if he's interested on both the 29th, probably 0 and the 30th. So we'll see. Anyways, enough of a blabber fest. I'm gonna hike down this road. I'm gonna get down to 34, stick my thumb out, and I'll let you know. I'll let you know how it goes. I'll talk to you guys probably up at the trailhead. All right, 7:43, just made it back to the Green Mountain Trailhead, 63.6 degrees. So I started hitching at 7:02. Down on the sort of fringes of Grand Lake, and got picked up in about 30 minutes. A nice guy from Southern California scooped me up in his RV, and he's just kind of cruising around the Colorado area with his telescope. Really, really interesting dude. Turns out he's like hiked Kilimanjaro and hitchhiked across the U.S. when he was younger and stuff like that. So cool dude. Pretty cool part about the hitchhiking is kind of finding out some of other people's stories and stuff. So anyways, yeah, only 30 minutes before I got picked up. It's only a 7 mile ride or so from where I was hitching to here, so it's not too bad at all. Now I just got to walk down 34 a little bit further, then the CDT is going to veer off to the west, and that is the direction I will be heading. So I will check in with you all later.
hiking after midnight out in the moonlight, just like we used to do. I'm always walking after midnight, searching for you. I walk for miles along the highway. Well, that's just my way.
Alright folks, good afternoon. It's 4:16 and 70.2 degrees. Just leaving this little like drainage creek trickle thing here. Decided to sit down, have dinner, and kind of look ahead at the rest of the day. Did have typical double pack of ramen for dinner. Brushed my teeth, which is nice, and I'm hiking with a clean mouth. That's always very nice. So today's a weird day. It's not been a bad day or anything. I mean, this burnout section is pretty sad, although it's got a lot of these wildflowers everywhere. I guess when the canopy's gone, these flowers just really take off, which is kind of nice. Oh man, that's a heavy pack. So the reason why it's a heavy pack is I loaded up 4 liters of water, so 8.8 pounds. The trail is kind of stays in this burnout for the next considerable stretch, and doesn't look like there's many fantastic camping spots or anything like that available for the next while. So I was kind of leaning towards just pitching up in whatever looked safest, which is almost a silly thing to say in this sort of environment. Safest, I mean, in terms of dead trees and deadfall and things like that, because all these trees are dead and burnt out. But then another aspiring CDT thru-hiker, American Joe Dirt, came by, had a snack, loaded up some water as well, and he mentioned that the next peak on the trail, I think it was called like Park View Lookout or something like that, that there's like a shelter up there of some sort, which sounds pretty cool. I haven't stayed in any shelters on this trail for sure, and I haven't seen very many at all either, so that would be a kind of cool thing to check out. But that is 6.4 miles, which isn't in and of itself too big of an ask, considering again it's only a quarter past four or whatever, but it is also 3,200 feet up, which starts to get starts to get a little challenging potentially here at the end of the day, especially again because it's 6.4 miles to the peak, and then another 4 miles beyond that is the next water source. So I'd have to be carrying up however much water I need to get there, plus however much water I want for breakfast, plus however much water I want to get 4 miles, which shouldn't be a lot. But breakfast plus bidet is usually about a liter. And, you know, I imagine if it's gonna be 6.4 miles at a decent grade, that'll probably be 2 liters to get up there. So all of a sudden, there you have it, 4 liters. Still haven't really super duper decided. I'd like to go check out that shelter, but I'm already 19 miles into the day. And I think getting over there will put me at whatever, 25 or 26 or something. We'll see. We'll see what we do. I'll be thinking about it, but boy, this heavy pack. Ooh, it's heavy. All right, anyways, whatever. I'll get hiking. I'll check in with you guys wherever I wind up. Alright guys, well, let me get you the time and temperature. It is 5:53. It is 62 degrees and it's pretty calm. There were some pretty significant dark clouds and maybe a little spit of rain, but nothing worth getting out the poncho for. There might even still be some dark clouds back here. It looks almost like nighttime falling in, but again, it's not yet 6 o'clock and it won't be dark for another 3 hours at least. You can probably tell I am not at a shelter. The dark clouds kind of humbled my ambitions a little bit. And then I also kind of realized like I've already done over 20 miles and that was on a late start, and it's only 71 miles to get to Steamboat. And I think tomorrow, hopefully I can do more than 25 to still kind of give myself a short day into Steamboat. Short meaning less than 20, hopefully. But we'll see, whatever. Even if it is a little more than 20, that's still perfectly manageable. And honestly, frankly, with my ankle that was kind of barking at the end of the last jump, it felt real good today and it felt great yesterday too. But I just thought, you know, there's really no reason to go 3 more miles to get to the summit on end of day legs with an ankle that was barking and, 8.8. pounds of water. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and give myself a pretty early night tonight. It'll give me a good opportunity to kind of like process the video I didn't process from my Slack pack yesterday, and hopefully process today's video too. And if not, at least get to bed halfway early. And this spot is just amazing. I mean, look at out here, man. It reminds me a little of a spot. I don't know. How many of you guys would know the Virginia Triple Crown, which is McAfee Knob, Tinker Cliffs, and Dragon's Tooth in sort of southwestern Virginia. But these rock formations kind of remind me of the Dragon's Tooth component of those three features that make up the Virginia Triple Crown. So it kind of feels like, I don't know, I mean, I guess I'm just a sucker for nostalgia or whatever, but it kind of makes it feel like home here. So that's kind of nice too. Let's see, anything really super duper to report today? Not really. I mean, camping here means I have, 3 plus 4, so 7 miles to get to my first water source, but that'll be fine. I mean, if I can get up and over that mountain in the morning, then hopefully I can have a nice cool morning to get up and over the mountain and then cruise downhill to get to the water source. And And that'll be good. I think that's it for me tonight. Yeah, that's it. Looking forward to another exciting day tomorrow. We're gonna have to wait until tomorrow to check out that shelter that I mentioned, or lookout, or whatever it is. Figure out exactly what that is. Wouldn't surprise me if I see another hiker or two come on by tonight. I did see Joe Dirt complimented the campsite I found and kept moving. I think he's just going like another mile or something. There was like some kind of dirt road or something that I think he was gonna pitch up on. But I asked him about it, and I guess he's an early riser, somewhat early riser as well. So maybe I'll be seeing him in the morning at some point tomorrow or whatever, I don't know. Either way, as I said before I started blabbering again, that's it for me tonight, guys. Really, really, really appreciate you all watching. Hope you had a great day as well. Hope you have a great evening. And I will definitely check in with you guys in the morning. Have a good one.